Joyce.
Hi, Jane. How are you?
Good. I brought my bee fabric for the beekeeper.
Oh, I love it.
Isn't it cute?
Isn't that wonderful?
I was worried that maybe the bees were too big, but I kind of gathered it at the store, and I think it's going to be okay.
Well, let's give it a try.
Okay.
All right.
I should check and see if she still has it.
I bet she does.
Okay. Now, we would normally put a hem in it, but we won't put a hem in just for this because we're going to do it kind of quick so that we can get a feel for what it's going to look like.
And she's very tense, and I say, just let the machine do the work.
Keep your fingers away. Yeah, that I'm sure is kind of not a good experience.
Yeah, so she keeps, when she sews, she keeps thinking about that thumb. And actually, I did that once. I put it through my pointer finger.
Ooh.
I was changing the needle. Didn't hurt going in, but it sure hurt
going out.
Remember
the tissue process and the whole hanger and all that?
Well, maybe when we go out to the bodies, we can do and then feed it in.
Right, okay.
So this is going to be her skirt.
Yeah, this is her skirt. And what other ideas did you have?
I was thinking of a little apron, a peplum kind of thing, and maybe a little white blouse with possibly a ruffle at the cuff.
Okay.
And then we probably need another color besides the peplum in the blouse. So,
okay.
Maybe a vest of some kind or some kind of over covering of her blouse.
Okay. All right, well, why don't we go to the fabric board?
Okay.
And see what we can find.
Okay.
I'm going to have to look at it for you. Yeah, now which one do you think would look good? You can just take them off and lay them on top. You know, just see which one you like, and I don't know.
I'm kind of liking this little gingham here.
Oh, I think that's great.
As a little. Okay. So this is going to be her skirt, and that will be her peplum.
Oh, I think that'll look great together. I love the combination. So
okay.
We probably need a color other than just black and white. You know, something to break it up a little bit.
Okay.
Maybe her vest or something that.
So probably a solid color, right?
Right. That would be my guess.
Okay. So how about like brown?
Oh, I like that. Don't you think that kind of adds something
to it? I do, because it almost looks like the bees are brown and not black.
Yeah.
I think it all blends. And then with her white blouse, I think it'll be perfect.
Okay. Well, let's go find some white, and
It's coming together.
We'll get some pieces of this, and we'll be give it a try.
Okay.
Pretty face.
Mm-hmm.
A woman's face.
A woman's face, yes.
Do you like that one?
Yeah, that would work. That's a pretty face, although it's hard to tell without any hair. She has lipsticks, pretty face, a little blush on her cheeks. She's going to be a beautiful beekeeper. I think we already have enough black. And there's a lot of blonde carolers. I think maybe this auburny red color would be pretty.
I like that too, because it'll show up nice against the hat, and at the same time, not stick out.
Okay, so here's the little bee skep. This would work for her holding a little something in her hand.
We'll pull one out so we can finish it in the sample.
That's a good one.
Okay.
I kind of like this hat with the ribbon around it. Here's one that's open.
Yeah, that'll be nice because we'll want to put some netting in front of her face so the bees don't sting her.
A basket maybe with some flowers of some kind.
Well, right here are some of her baskets, and again,
okay.
You just kind of have to dig around and you never know what you're going to find.
It's like a nice Easter basket.
Yeah, this one is maybe too dark.
Yeah, I think that's too dark with her fabric.
And it'll be too dark with this, I think.
I like this one here.
That's a good one.
And that's a tray.
Right.
So I think maybe this would be the winner.
Let's take one and find out. Let's see, black-eyed Susans or sunflower. These may be too big.
I think those are going to be too big.
Yeah, I think so too.
So that you know that would work.
These are pretty little roses, but that's an encore too. I'm thinking maybe these little flowers.
Oh, those are nice.
Is this too big?
We'll take them both and we'll fry them. And, and how about some greens to maybe break up some of the yellow?
Greens would be perfect because a florist would do a bouquet.
Yes. Okay. Well, let's put this all together real quickly and see if we have a good combination. We have our yellow skirt, the black and white, the brown, and the white.
Perfect.
Yeah, let's give it a try.
I have a straw.
It's of some kind, but yeah, it has a lot of petals on for a daisy, doesn't it?
It's almost like those spider mums, but with a bigger center.
Right, that's true.
She's gonna love it.
Perfect. Oh, that looks beautiful. First the apron. Looks great.
That's cute. I like that. You can see her whole personality coming together.
Already?
Yes. Just with two pieces of fabric.
Now does she remind you of your mother?
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay.
Not yet. I don't know that my mom ever
had a black checked apron.
Did anything with bees either, but yeah. Other than used honey.
Okay, so over here we have some pans. Make pins in the United States.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
With this type of head on it. Okay, so there we have one.
Can you order different, like these are all red-headed pins. Can you order different color pin heads and get like 1,000 red heads?
Like a million.
So you can buy them in separate colors, I guess.
Right, we have them custom made.
Oh.
Yep. And like I said, I don't know how many exactly we have to buy, but it's a lot.
Yeah, because it makes your little holly with the holly berry in the middle.
That's right.
Perfect.
And all of our buttons are actually little pins.
And I guess
you
have a piece of holly. Yeah. And I guess depending on where you're going to put the pin on the caroler depends on the color.
See how this
looks on this particular figure. Perfect.
So far, so good?
Look how pretty she is. She has such a pretty face.
I like her face. That's one of my favorites. I'll take a little chunk of this. Just to finish it off a little bit. Wow, she's almost finished. Would you believe that? Now, we're just going to do this. Just kind of pretend about the hat for a few minutes. Because what we're going to do is take it to the sewing... industrial sewing machines and have them put some netting on it.
Okay.
Okay.
As a finishing touch, we just added this little bumblebee. It was buzzing around the garden and it landed right there. Don't you just love our new exclusive?
Oh, I think she's absolutely wonderful. I really do like her.
What do you like about her?
I like the netting over the face. I like the beehive, her flowers, her dress. I think everything is absolutely perfect.
And her name is? Bessie the Beekeeper.
Bessie the Beekeeper, that's perfect.
What do you think of our new store exclusive?
I love her. She's gorgeous.
Isn't she precious?
She's adorable. I want her.
You can't have her till March 15th.
No, that's too far away.
You have to wait.